Hello everyone, and welcome back to Abaddon the Black Fortress. And we continue our quest, Nathalie's personal quest to deal with Josa Mindtaker, that extremely annoying Drake that tried to deal with our minds and run away in the end through the particular. And finally, we or Nathalie found it, and so we'll go and help her and deal with that dragon, giving satisfaction to ourselves and to Nathalie. And in the last episode, we found Nathalie, and now actually we should be able to find Josa as well in this tower instead of infinite staircase. Okay, you look at the abyss. Anything burst apart recently struck the surface. Whatever message was written here, it has been destroyed. My fault, Nathalie mutters. Spelled went awry when I was finding my way out. Was just a list of names and dates. Nothing important. Okay then. Can you open this door or something, Nathalie? Let's go bottom to the staircases. Maybe Nathalie can do something about it. Nathalie walks up to a wall, touches it with her uninjured hand and grimaces. She's in pain. This is as far as I got before the ogres found me. Had to flee, but let us continue downward. It is an illusion. I can break it within time. Okay, so apparently that's what we do. We go in the bottom and let her break the solution. Nathalie stops again. At first, you think that her injured arm is bothering her. It is, but that's not why she stopped. She walks up to a wall and touches it. Nothing happens. She walks across the hall and touches the opposite wall. Nothing happens. She smiles. Then she mutters a word. The wall vanishes in an instant, revealing a natural talent beyond. Every hour I spend here, I can see through more of the tricks. Others may fear it. I am a hunter. Okay. Then, hunter, let's go and hunt a trick. But now it seems like we just hunt some undeads. That's also fine. Corrupted dead. I wonder if they are randomly immune to fire or something. Well, yeah, let's wait and then come a bit closer to them. And start combat. Lost Soul and others are just corrupted dead. Like nameless somebody. Okay, let's go here and kill it. And we got level up for time. That's good. There is too much soul. So lost soul is actually not a unique chant for 3 turns. Ouch. Okay then. I guess I have no choice. My poor archer will have to tank all that. Well, now Tristram out of charm? I thought he had more rounds. But okay. He really needs a lot more mind effect resistance. I really want to put on this silk woven corp. Okay, let's take a level. It doesn't look like I get this intelligence now, and I don't really want to spend points here. On the other hand, do I really need more endurance? Probably I still need it. But intelligence itself increases the chance to miss for mental attacks. Well, it doesn't actually influence it directly. Endurance influences acid and poison. Let's take a look. No, it doesn't. Well, okay, let's take intelligence. You convinced me. I really want a bit of that defense. I want to put that item on. And I need this triumphant to help others before I can give away that scarab with mental defense. Okay. That will do, and now let's put this silk woven cord on. We will really need it. That is real, real use. Okay, that is. Yeah. Nobody really needs this girdle. I'll keep it for now. Maybe I will use it against I don't know who. Some kind of boss, which only deals physical damage. Maybe. We'll see. Anyway, let's take a look how much metal resistance we have now. 38%. Wait. Shouldn't it add 15%? It was 27. So actually this 3% includes mental resistance. It's like all resistances. Interesting. Okay. You like guess mind resistance a bit more important than all these hostile effect resistances. And I'm using, yeah, I'm using hostile effect resistance and dragon scale landing boots. Yeah, I don't need this stomping box then, that's for sure. Okay. Fine. And I will not need this shield of recovery as well then. Let's sell it. Sure. Okay, and let's continue here, trying to find the Drake, that is Josa. Mm-hmm. The way to the bottom. Shima notes the old slightly tarnished razor disc on the floor nearby. Interesting. That would indicate that the building is of archaic Hawkland and construction. This would be interesting evidence to support my people's claim that these woods were originally ours. I would report it to my homeland, but I still welcome to there. Yeah, oh, okay. Laser disc, useless. Let's sell them. What do we have here? Some runes. Nothing happened when we stepped on it. Some altar. Is there some buttons or something? Huh? You feel an icy sensation all over your skin. You shudder uncontrollably for several seconds. Then the sensation fades. Okay, let's go in a different direction. Well, apparently I need to go in round and round, or something like that. Oh, yeah, there is an obelisk. The writing on this obelisk is in a language you can't understand. You look at it briefly and then, oh wait! It's entirely readable. It was hard to tell in the shadows. It says, into the circle. Circle to the circle with the altar on your left. Circle on the circle and reverse. Circle to the circle with the altar on your right. Circle onto the circle and to the darkness. Okay, which altar to my left? That should be like this, right? No, an opposite direction. Okay, warm sensation. Okay, let's go here. No sensations, fine. Altar to the left. Okay, circle. Here, now circle the circle. I'm not sure how am I supposed to do that. And now reverse. Right? Like this. You finish your loop around the circle and step into the magic circle. There is a brief draft of cool air. You look at the north wall, where before there was an obelisk, now there is only a gap in the wall. Okay? That was a bit strange, but whatever. Let's go further. You enter another large hall. The smells of dust and decay are heavy in the air. You can see several coffins lining the wall. Someone has smashed the lids of most of them. There are no signs of the break. There are, however, trapdoors. Dozens of them, all arranged in rows on the floor. Continuing downstairs seems deceptively easy. Natalie leans against the wall, exhausted but determined to continue. She says,
"What? This don't feel the Drake is strongly here. This might be the tower's defenses, not the beasts. Still dangerous. You need to pass."
Okay. Where do we go? Into which of these trapdoors? Alright, let's pick items first because we can. Of course, most of them was smashed open. Probably we should go into those that wasn't. Maybe. Hard to say. Anything, is this magic circle? Nothing. Well, let's try to go in into, I don't know, this trapdoor. Let's try. Okay, and my tank was teleported into the middle and some trash was summoned. And trapdoor disappeared. Okay, I see. So I just activate all these trapdoors one by one and kill whatever is found. Fine with me? Easy enough. Well, you missed me with your charm. That's good news for me and bad for you. Okay, you charmed my turn. Whatever. Now we can end combat, right? No, we can't. Because my tank is my enemy. Okay, whatever. Whatever you say. Okay, that's all of that. Cool. Let's open another trapdoor. Okay, and now we open the right one. Somehow. Fine. Right and right. Maybe later we can go back and open all the rest to just go get ourselves more speed. If there is more enemies that will come. That way. For now, let's continue here and try to get in whatever you can. Well, it seems like dead end. You look around this empty crypt, trying to find a way down. The stairway behind you is the only exit. The sensation of the drag being nearby is completely gone. This icy hole must be lowest level of the crypt. Natalie looks at the throne intently.
No! This is something I've missed. I sometimes something's coming.
You feel it too. A hidden malevolent presence in the center of the room. It is the specter of a figure in the black robes. The clothes look like the garb of a shadow worker, but many years of it is dead. As the spirit draws its spectral blade and stalks towards you, the rubble in the side alcoves begins to shift under its own power. The bricks reform themselves into golems. However, the constructs don't move. They stand guard in the alcoves. Odd. Okay. Let them do so, then. And the spirit. Okay, I think we can hide from them, so they don't cast stuff on us. Let's go here. And you go here. Stand right next to the throne. Pick up whatever trash is here. And mage, you also hide, please. Can we shoot you now? Well, you are immune. Ah, so that's the thing. You probably immune to everything until we kill this guardian. Am I right? Well, not really, but almost. As you engage the shade in battle, the spirits in alcoves begin to chant. It's a low monotone hum that makes the stone vibrate and disappear. A faint glowing membrane appears around the ghostly shadow wall. You find that your blows are sliding off of your foe, barely damaging it. Okay, I see what you're doing here. Then I will first kill these guardians. And yes, and I will block you, chunk. Okay, you have it. Let's kill these guardians and kill this spirit. Ouch! You're strong. I can't even come close to you. Let's destroy this alcove guardian. And let's use this move. Ouch. I miscalculated my AP. Okay. Can I shoot this shielding spirit? No. Well, I can shoot this guardian then. Hey, stop shooting my mage. Would you? Please? Let's hide my mage a bit farther away from this guy and use skill spell for her. Yeah, she is basically immune to magic, but not so immune to physical. Well, I can't hit anybody much for damage. Yeah, fine. I'll attack you for 1 damage, because why not? Let's kill these shielding spirits. One less. The faint glowing protective shield that surrounds the ghost flashes brightly. Then it fades. Something has caused the protective aura to grow weaker. Well, something, obviously, what was that something? Yeah, now I actually do some damage to him. Fine. Let's take it to me. Can I shoot him? No, I bet not. I bet I don't. Let's go and kill others first. Like this guy. And you just go and try to back him to the corner. More than actually damaging him. Okay, Alcove Guardian is done. Ouch. One again. You go forward and eat a bit more meat. How much AP you actually use when you eat that meat? Hard to say. Okay, you go and kill that spirit. I've had enough of this shade. You can't move anymore. Whatever. Let's kill spirits first. Shooting spirits. Okay. Now we're going for this spirit at the bottom. Well, you stay there, try to deal with my tank. Just don't come close, okay? Let's eat more meat. And destroy this guy here. And the last one left. My tank is still fine, don't you worry. You can continue hitting him. No one cares. Not tank, for sure. Now I do a bit more damage. 38. Okay then, there is only one left. The last shielding spirit. And now you can't run away, Shade. You can. And the last shielding spirit. And now I can start killing you. Well, still not much damage, but more than one damage, right? Well, stunning my tank won't save you, that's for sure. And finally, with a final blow, you cleave through the spectral energy holding the spirit together. The entire state crumbles up, as if it was as thin as a piece of paper, and then fades away. It remains servants crumble as well, leaving you surrounded by piles of smoking rock. Well, there was no servants anymore, so... And yet, despite all of your efforts, just a main taker is still nowhere to be seen. Well, we'll get to her, don't you worry. Now that the spectral distraction have been cleared away, Natalie is free to concentrate. She turns to you.
As I was saying before I was interrupted, I know now. I know what that Drake is doing, where it is hiding. We must go back upstairs to the entry hall and hurry, there may be a little time.
Okay. Yes, thank you. Thank you very much. Titan Steel Razor Disc, at last. It's actually not that much better than Steel Razor Disc, though. Funny enough, it's just like 4... something damage, like 5% better. Well, okay, still I'll take it. Bracelet of Opportunity, chance to repost. I don't think anybody needs that. Even my tongue don't need it. Like, seriously. Like, it don't have any harm or even. I'll sell it. Okay. Let's hurry up back. And then maybe we'll come back. Wait. We'll not back, maybe. We'll still take these rubies. Yeah. And now let's hurry up back to the Josamine Taker. And later we'll come back and probably open all of these trapdoors. Right? Because they probably will give me XP, you know? Let's go back. Let's go. Come on. Where? As you walk through this crumbling hall, Nathalie looks around and then...
Yes, here! I feel him! There!
She points at the circle to the north. You look at the circle. It's empty and dusty as before, Nathalie says.
Am I the only one who can see past the switches, right? Look again!
And you do. You concentrate. Then you see the bag, Translucence 54. You concentrate directly upon it. Little by little, your mind pierces the illusion. Josamine Taker was here all along, standing perfectly still, but killing itself. Josa let out a long, disgusted scroll.
I have you found! I suspected as much that I must face you. Come, I'm ready!
Yeah, sure. You are ready. Let's start the combat. What are those? Not sure. Okay, let's come closer. Can we attack her, actually? Yes, I have to talk with her. Okay, Josamine Taker watches you as you approach. The creature is visibly weaker than he was when you first fought him. His scales are cracked and losing their color, and his eyes are losing some of their glow. His battles, first with you and then with Nathalie, have taken a harsh toll. At last, he has no choice but to face you directly.
But I found me! I thought I would leave me behind! I thought you had worse for something! You are your real man, mate! She's persistent. Now I will run away from her life.
You think I will let you leave?
Your hand of Abaddon! All hands have the price!
Nathalie snorts. Do I really need to parallel with you? No, I will just kill you. The very Drake instantly adopts a battle stance.
Yes, I will face you. I'm tired, but not so warm that I will reject a proper challenge.
As you advance on the creature, its form starts to blow. Other Drake's perfect copies of Josa begin to appear on the same.
Now you will both fight me and the images of me in your mind.
Yeah, something like that. Anyway, let's spray them and see if all of them take the same damage. Well, it looks like. Anyway, let's find out if they are in the final. They're not. You strike one of Josa's copies with a savage blow. The creature roars in anger. Droplet of blood strike the stone floor and start to hiss. They don't disappear. You realize that the Josa you struck is a real one. He roars in anger. Then the images of the creature shifts and vanishes. You suddenly are no longer sure where the true Josa is. Okay. You heavily damage one of the copies of Josa. It pops like a bubble. There is no trace of it, or its tracks, or the blood it has spilled. All of Josa's other images cackles on perfect use. I actually damaged three of them at once? That's probably a real Josa mind taker. If I had to guess, this one is real. Let's go for him. Oh, so new appeared here. Okay, so these two are not here. That's what you're telling me. Okay, let's attack this one then. And you go and try to, well, a lot of them appear. Suddenly, that's a problem. Yes, that's a problem. I actually damaged a real one, I think, but they're actually all perfectly fine. Is this the real one? Or is this the real one? Let's take deal damage to all of them, because I know. Yeah, I struck the real one. He shimmers and fades away. That was a real. Okay. Fine. Which one is the real now? We continue these games. Is this real? Let's just hit them randomly, because why not? And let's see our move. Once again, you have struck and wounded the true Josa. He lets out a long, low moan of pain. Your blows are starting to wear him down. However, his power remains. The true image vanishes and the other shades flow together and disappear. Yeah, so I guess I have just to attack them randomly and eventually I will use a real one when the power will build. You struck the real again and again. Yeah. I'm just striking all of you just randomly because, yep, I can. Can I do some area of effect damage here? I can't. Well, okay, just continue striking them. Actually, I clip them. Did I hit real one this time? Looks like I didn't. One of these three should be the real one. Oh, whatever. We'll continue hitting them. Just continue. And that was the real one. Okay. Where now is the real one here? I mean, maybe. Let's continue striking them. You also attack somebody. And you attack somebody. Now, no real one. Let's strike this one. Let's strike this one. And this one. I think I strike all of them at once. That should be the real one among them, right? Or I didn't strike you, so you didn't punish. You deliver a vicious blow to the true Josa. The illusion covering his body fades, and you can see how grievous you have wounded him. The pain and loss of blood prevent him from maintaining the illusion. The shades fade away, and you are left with the Drake himself, alone and pathetic.
My last, he gasps. My last powers, they remain.
Yeah, your last power, you can say so. Terrified. Well, okay, you terrified. terrified my Ashima. Not good. And you even charmed him. Well, that means that I can dispel both at once. Doesn't it? No, I actually only cure one and then. Well, I cure two, even though it says one. Okay, I'm fine with that. Now, Josa, it looks like you are done. You were so smart. So illusionary. With the final blow, Josa Mindtaker falls to the ground. Slain. You barely have time to approach the body before a lance of fire strikes you. And then a bolt of ice. And then more fire. Nastali screams in fury as she blasts the corpse into the air. Then she turns away, gasping for breath.
I won! That's the glory! My arm, it hurts. I thank you. Please come. I'm ever in you that. Let us go home. No problem.
Well, we will, of course. But first I want to clean this place fully. And yeah, a robe of sorceress. Just for you. Nathalie, this is your reward. This is notably better than just magical mastery. Word mastery, intelligence and plus 2 to firebolt and even 20 armor. You would be insanely strong now. Students armor, you don't need that anymore. Okay, before we go any further, can I open this door? Yes, I can. Cool. Then let's loot what we have here, and also go to the bottom of the tower and attack all other trapdoors. There should be marks before us. Jade Halberd. Huh, interesting. Melee damage, poison resistance, acid resistance, blessing and curses. Okay, I don't need Halberd, but it was nice of him. We'll sell it. Somebody else might need it. Okay, now let's go to the bottom and check first the other trapdoors that are remaining. Oh, by the way, did I check these places? No, I didn't. Let's take whatever's inside then. And go to the bottom of this crypt and see what we can get from this trapdoor. Okay, just in case, I will save because who knows how long it will take. I might even do it between episodes. This was what? This one was empty. Now, okay, you teleported Shima. I don't want Shima to be teleported there. I will be fine with my tongue though. But okay, let's kill him. These guys, more lost souls to kill. Can you put charm in my guns? Especially like my Shima. I mean, stop charming them. Thank you. Thank you very much. Those were spawns, by the way. Let's wait to regenerate our HP and open more trapdoors. This just disappeared. This one also. This one empty. More souls? Yes, here they are. More souls. Let's use some area of effect magic, like cone of fire. That should be fine. That should work for them. Good damage. Let's kill this one. Okay. Any more XP for me? I wonder how much XP they give me, actually. Let's check more trapdoors. Yes, this one we checked and that was the other way. Round, okay. Let's check more trapdoors. Nothing. More slot stalls. Cool. More XP for me. Thanks. Let's set up this one. Okay, let's continue. Anything here? No. Those are all empty. Okay, more souls. Oh, I had my archer inside. Oh, okay. Whatever. Should be also fine. Well, and last, everybody's charmed. Really? You're really all charmed. Okay then, okay. Charmed and stunned. Yeah, okay. Now you can continue trying to kill this lost soul. And one lost soul actually running around, kind of, for no reason. Okay. And those one was somewhat hard. Because they charmed everybody they can charm, basically. Okay, more of them. Let's take my shimmer out of there. And no, I don't really need razor spray. And you go in. Are you serious? Going all of you all at once for my shimmer? Okay. You are not good. You are not. Here, take some corn fire. I hope you like it. Okay, anything they dropped? Nothing. Okay, let's continue trying to get more XP like this. Touch more and more. And more came. And again, they took my archer. Well, now that was too critical, it means minus two lost souls. You don't need the charm. Okay, you're fine without it. Shima. Let's finish this also. Finally. What is it here? Yet another trap with lost souls. This time they took Nathalie. Okay, Nathalie, you run away and shoot them. Shimon is charmed again. And actually my tongue is also charmed. Ow. And I can't really run. Ow. That's not good. And I even missed this look. Ouch. Backstab. Really? Well, okay, let's heal. Shima, now you're no longer charmed. Please kill these guys with a razor blade. They're really annoying. And you use. Yes, cone of fire. Really. All three of them all at once. Okay, let's wait a bit. We need all our cooldowns and all status effects to disappear. Okay, and this is empty, 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 and the last one also empty. Okay, it seems like we cleared all the HP we had here. Good. We don't have any reason to remain here. Okay. So now that ends our quest with Natalie, which was surprisingly short. Just two episodes, not three like other ones. At last, victorious, you emerge from the tower. The drake that infested it is gone, and the domes are free to crumble in peace. You look across the water and the tree line. Now that the tree drake is gone, the woods look different. You wonder what has been concealed and is now exposed. As you walk out in the cool, fresh air, Natalie makes a strange choking noise. She comes close to being overcome with emotion, but she maintains control.
I need to return to Avadon. My arm requires tending, she mutters. It should not have happened. Had Avadon done its duty, I was left behind it, alone. Their fault, their...
She turns and sees that you are listening. She continues to mutter. But I'm okay. Well, it was not their fault, and you know that, but okay, but really before we go back, I will just check whatever is left here, probably not much, or probably much. Okay, let's check what was hidden in the woods and the next episode of Abandon the Platform. So I hope you like this episode, leave your like and subscribe. And subscribe, and I will see you in the next episode of Avadon the Black Fortress. Bye bye.